I know it's Friday, but you guys need to know this before the weekend starts. While Germany is failing, huge losses, we have Jamie Dimon right now dumping all of his stocks. Now, cue the fire. Does this mean that we should be dumping JP Morgan? No, you have to look at the charts. Because as one goes up, another one goes down. I don't know if you guys caught HSBC taking a huge hit. So as the stock market goes up, I am going to show you that we're in a recession. I know, isn't that crazy? But repeat after me. The stock market, I've been saying this for 5 years. The stock market is not the economy. But coming in from Sprechen Sie Deutsch, German central bank losses soar. A lot of bank losses soar. Why is that? Because we're all connected. That darn Asia thing, it's a spreading. But it is completely wiping out risk provisions. I don't know if you guys caught this. The German, and then we'll get to Jamie Dimon in a second, annual distribution profit of, here, I'll highlight it for you, zero. But it's okay, you guys. The politicians will tell you the Bundesbank can bear financial burdens until it can't. And this, my friends, is the face of it can't. Actually, I think this is a first time. ECB on Thursday posted its first annual loss since 2004. Eh? We coming into 08 again? Jamie Dimon sees the writing on the wall and he's taking profit. Hopefully you guys are all taking profit. JP Morgan, CEO Jamie Dimon, sells about 150 million of his shares. Of the shares. Man, this guy wins. JP Morgan Chase CEO Jamie Dimon sold about 150 million of his shares in the bank. The SEC filing showed on Thursday of all of the elites getting out at the top, but just bringing all retail in, marking the first time the head of the largest U.S. lender has sold shares since taking charge since when? 2005. That, does that mean that we should be selling? Actually, the market, a little sell, a little buy, a little flat. I will show you in this video that most stocks, you guys, I'm sorry, they're not the Mag 7. And even the guy who coined the phrase Mag 7 is like, yeah, that's gone. Very simply, before all my indicators pop up, see the yellow line? That's the 200. You trade it going up. So this is JP Morgan Chase. So right now, right above my finger. Oh, there's my indicators. See, there is a point where right here, I can't touch it because I don't have a green screen behind me. Right here, the nine count comes on. It looks something like this, and I'll show you a trade right now. It was in my watch list. This is what I do. These are actually the setups that I look for. Now, some people will go, oh, that's really religious. You're under the 200. Guys, you're a candle away. Boom. One candle, nine count. Purple Nurple. Also, take advantage of my swing trading course so you can learn how to do this. Whatever specials I'm running down below, and you ride it. And you wait, and not just for Purple Nurple, you need another nine count. I've never seen it go that purple without a nine count showing. Actually, it showed right there. But you would have exited your position right there. You guys know this. I search every day on my watch list for these types of setups. This was HON. It was up 40, just since Tuesday, up 42%. While everyone is focused on the Mag 7 or, you know, Bitcoin or whatever, or gold or silver, I do this all day long. Let me zoom in. See the yellow line? Same setup. Let me zoom in before my indicators all kick on. This is your setup right here. Nine count came on. Boom. Beat down. One candle close all day long. Actually, link in the description if you want to look at my options, what I trade every day, options, one contract, just paper trading. Actually, you guys did 7 days for free to go, wow, he's legit. I get emails from you guys all the time, comments. I don't know if this guy's true. It was 4 hours ago, just popped up. My 1250 put paid 1,154%. As one bank goes up, another bank goes down. HSBC down. Look at that, 9%. HSBC stocks falling on $3 billion hit from where? China operations. Wah, wah, wah. So again, you got to be all over the place. You can't, you know, if we were to look at HSBC, it's probably under the 200. I'm just taking a guess. And you know what's going to be crazy is this might be the first time we're in a recession. We're going into a recession. Japan's in a recession. Market, it's not all-time high. They still haven't beat the 80s. Imagine, they're still holding their shares from Duran Duran. But anyways, to each his own. Look not at GDP. Look at GDI. GDI, and thanks to GOAT for putting out this chart that's all over the interwebs. But GDI is a better predictor of recessions. It's a better, not predictor, but what's happening right now? Money going in, money going out. And actually, this goes back to the Great Depression with 100% accuracy. So we is in a recession, whether Joey B likes it or not. Actually, pretty sure when we change ownership in the White House, then it'll be like, oh, the one side will tell the other side, we're in a depression now. While the whole world is in a recession, just got this coming in right now, today, just a few hours ago from NBC. So thank you for supporting the channel so I can pay all these people money to get the stuff that that you guys want. But I think they're figuring this out here. Developed markets around the world seem to be trading at record highs. That's weird, but they're in a recession. The S&P on Thursday surged to a fresh all-time high and had its biggest one-day jump in over a year, which it is tough when I come here. I show you the macro stuff. I don't trade macro, you guys. I'm just telling you what it is. If the whole world is burning and the stock market's going up, I don't know. I'm trading the stock market. Actually, crazy story. I heard from one of my financial friends who I've had on the channel. I did not put it on because it was really kind of, it didn't sit comfortably. But remember when those planes landed on the buildings, in the buildings, and the buildings came down? There were actually traders that were sitting there watching it, knowing what's going to happen, but yet shorting the market. And let's just say the story did not have a happy ending. But as we had the Nikkei cross 39,000, reached a record for the first time since 89, right? That's what I was saying, which is crazy. You guys are in a recession and it's not all-time highs, but bull market. So please do not confuse. And in the comment section, every time I see it, I just want to punch myself in the face. I could have made so much money if I didn't listen to you. No, you couldn't have, because you're in your mom's basement and you have nothing good to say. I come here working every single day, giving you the macro with macro thumb titles and then going into the charts. Also, congratulations to NVIDIA, who's carrying this entire market. But guys, I hope you know, and most people on this channel, you have investors. I just beg you to do it yourself. I meet with Bankster. I can't tell you how many Bankster phone calls I took this morning. So I get it. But you're probably, you know, hey, what are you investing all my money in? And I say, you need to do your own. You need to learn how to trade yourself rather than giving it to someone else. If you look above my head, you have mid cap, small cap, and Russell 2000. Those have been flat. I mean, they've bumped a little bit. While the S&P 500 booming, which on this channel in October, I said I'm going all in. Well, I mean, for the percentages that I use. But I'm taking out a buy. What was it? The 200-day moving average. It was a beatdown. Nine count came on. Purple nurple. One candle close. I wrote it. And then I exited when it closed below. And I took my profit. Now, I have S&P 500. You guys know this since, geez, when I started teaching, I'm like, okay, I guess I'll just listen to what they have. And I actually put it in SPY. That's been sitting there. Yes, that account, record high. Am I touching it? No, it's a retirement. I'm not into penalties. Also, this comes from Real Investment Advice, Lance Roberts. The guy's a goat. On the small cap, people are actually, not people, large institutions that have your money are actually going into small cap thinking that's where the NVIDIA play is going to be, but it's not. All right, but now let's move on to the housing market, which is different than the stock market, which is different than the economy, which is different than China, Japan, Germany. Get ready for keeping those 6% forever. Home foreclosures see notable increase amid ongoing cost of living crisis. See, the world is in crisis. Foreclosures are booming, but does that mean market go down? No. Well, actually, it looks like the NASDAQ, I got to get back to trading, down half, S&P 500 down. Dow's taking a little pop right there. Recession is coming. Who cares? Okay, great. And it could send stocks plummeting 26% as dwindling savings rate. Oh, come on. You guys, really? Savings rate? Stock market? What? That's the strategist? Who is this? Got a BCA strategist. Okay, 26%. Again, once the economy slips into contraction, stocks could plunge by 26%. She warned. Okay, she. So cue the fire. Don't care. Don't care recession. Don't care macro. Guys, trade the charts in front of you if you want your digits going higher. Take advantage of whatever I offer. Or just do what you've done your whole life. If that's working, keep doing that. And I will keep coming here every day telling you what they're saying, what I'm saying, and what's going on behind the scenes. And I will see you tomorrow.